Bismillah, elhamdülillah, ve salatu ve selamu ala Resulillah. Nebiyyina Muhammedin ve alihi ve sahbihi ve men valah. Ama ba'd. İnşallah we have the class of tafsir from Suratu Ali Imran. From verse 83. Suratu Ali Imran, that's Surah 3. Verse 83. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم أفغير دين الله يبغون وله أسلم من في السماوات والأرض طوعا وكرها وإليه يرجعون قل آمنا بالله وما أنزل علينا وما أنزل على إبراهيم وإسماعيل وإسحاق ويعقوب والأسباط وما أوتي موسى وعيسى والنبيون من ربهم لا نفرق بين أحد منهم ونحن له مسلمون ومن يبتغي غير الإسلام دينا فلن يقبل منه وهو في الآخرة من الخاسرين. الله عز وجل said in this ayah, verse 83 from Surah Ali Imran, أَفَغَيْرَ دِينِ اللَّهِ يَبْغُونَ. Do they seek other than the religion of Allah? Do they want other than the religion of Allah? وَلَهُ أَسْلَمَ مَنْ فِي السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ طَوْعًا وَكَرْهًا. While to him alone submit all the creatures in the heaven and in the earth. While to him, Allah, submit all creatures in the heaven and in the earth, willingly and unwillingly, or unwillingly. وَإِلَيْهِ يُرْجَعُونَ. And to him alone shall they all be returned. يقول أهل العلم هذا استفهام إنكاري. This is a question of a negation. Means it shouldn't be. Do they seek other than the religion of Allah as a religion? So that shouldn't happen. They shouldn't seek other than the religion of Allah as a religion. So in this ayah that no one should take religion other than Islam, the religion of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because it is from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. How someone leave off that which is from Allah and instead takes that which is from other than Allah. Rather, the religion of Allah, al-Islam, should be the only religion considered a religion, for it is the haq, the truth. Allah said, أَفَغَيْرَ دِينِ اللَّهِ يَبْغُونَ. Do they seek other than the religion of Allah, the true Islamic monotheism, worshipping none but Allah alone? وَلَهُ أَسْلَمَ مَنْ فِي السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ طَوْعًا وَكَرْهًا. While to him submit all creatures in the heaven and in the earth, willingly or unwillingly. All the creatures of the universe, of the heaven and the earth, all of them, without exception, submit to Allah's command. Either the universal command, al-amrul kawni, or religious command, al-amru shar'i. All the creatures submit themselves to Allah. All the creatures. But there are two kinds. One kind who do that willingly. The believers, the angels. Believers from man, believers from the jinn. And the other creatures of Allah, who obey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala willingly, like the heaven and the earth. When Allah created the earth and the heaven, He commanded them to come to Him subhanahu wa ta'ala. قَالَتَ أَتَيْنَا طَائِعِينَ. They say, we came willingly, obeying. So the heaven and the earth obey Allah تبارك وتعالى. قُلْ أَيْنَكُمْ لَتَكْفُرُونَ بِالَّذِي خَلَقَ الْأَرْضَ فِي يَوْمَيْنِ وَتَجْعَلُونَ لَهُ أَنْدَادًا ذَلِكَ رَبُّ الْعَالَمِينَ وَجَعَلَ فِيهَا رَوَاسِيَ مِنْ فَوْقِهَا وَبَارَكَ فِيهَا وَقَدَّرَ فِيهَا أَقْوَاتَهَا فِي أَرْبَعَةِ أَيَّامٍ سَوَاءً لِلسَّائِلِينَ ثُمَّ اسْتَوَى إِلَى السَّمَاءِ وَهِيَ دُخَانٌ فَقَالَ لَهَا وَلِلْأَرْضِ ائْتِيَا طَوْعًا أَوْ كَرْهًا فَقَالَ لَهَا لِلسَّمَاءِ وَلِلْأَرْضِ ائْتِيَا طَوْعًا أَوْ كَرْهًا قَالَتَا أَتَيْنَا طَائِعِينَ. Review Surah Fussilat. Allah Azza wa Jal talked to the heaven and to the earth. Allah talked to them. They heard Allah and they answer and they talk back. The heaven and the earth, the skies and the earth. فَقَالَ لَهَا. Allah said to the heavens, وَلِلْأَرْضِ and to the earth, ائْتِيَا. Come. Allah commanded them to come to Him. قَالَتَا أَتَيْنَا. They said, both the heaven and the earth said, أَتَيْنَا. We came, we arrived, we came. طَائِعِينَ. While we are willingly obeying. Of course, to a human being, it's ununderstandable. How heaven talk, how the earth talk to Allah, how it understands, perceives Allah's command, how it talks. We don't understand that. But that is the truth. Rather, Allah mentioned in His book that all the creatures glorify Him and remember Him. Allah said in Surah Isra, وَإِن مِّن شَيْءٍ إِلَّا يُسَبِّحُ بِحَمْدِهِ. Nothing exists but it glorifies Allah while at the same time praising Him. Everything. وَإِن مِّن شَيْءٍ شَيْءٍ نَكَرَ فِي سِيَاغٍ شَرْطٍ تُفِيدُ الْعُمُومِ. Everything glorify Allah and remembers Allah. Allah said, وَلَكِنْ لَا تَفْقَهُونَ تَسْبِحًا. But you don't perceive. Oh man, you don't understand how they make tasbih. How they creatures of Allah glorify Allah. You don't understand. But that's what happened. So the believer believes that those galaxies out there, those stars, the sun and the moon, the earth, the tree, the birds, the creatures, all of it, without exception, remember Allah. Obey Allah. وَإِن مِّن شَيْءٍ إِلَّا يُسَبِّحُ بِحَمْدِ وَلَكِنْ لَا تَفْقَهُونَ تَسْبِحَهُمْ. But you don't understand their tasbih. You don't understand how they glorify Allah. أَلَمْ تَرَ أَنَّ اللَّهَ يُسَبِّحُ لَهُ مَنْ فِي السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ وَالطَّيْرُ صَافَّاتٍ كُلٌّ قَدْ عَلِمَ صَلَاتَهُ وَتَسْبِيحَهُ. Each of those mentioned, including the birds, know it is tasbih and salah. It is prayer. And it is tasbih, glorification to Allah Azza wa Jalla. وَالنَّجْمُ وَالشَّجَرُ يَسْجُدَانِ. Allah said the وَالنَّجْمُ, the star, وَالشَّجَرُ, the tree, both make sujood, bow down to Allah Azza wa Jalla. All the creatures. This is the aqidah of Al-Islam. There were, Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said, I know, he said when he was in Medina, he said he remembered a rock which used to greet him in Mecca time. A camel, she camel, complained to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam from the owner. And Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam did understood that. And he blamed the owner of that she camel. When Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam went to move from the old member he used to stand when he giving talk, which was at, and to move to a new member, the old one cry. Just like, and the Sahaba, they heard it, until the Prophet ﷺ grabbed it and hugged it and made it quiet. Prophet Muhammad ﷺ was one day on the top of the mountain of Uhud, and it moved. The mountain, it moved. Prophet ﷺ, he hit it with his feet and said, Uhud, stop. Nothing is on you but the Prophet, Siddiq, and two martyrs, two shuhada. With the Prophet ﷺ was Abu Bakr and Umar and Uthman. And Abu Bakr, Prophet ﷺ was the Prophet of Allah. Abu Bakr was Siddiq, and Umar and Uthman were killed. Ridwanullah ta'ala alayhi. So Prophet ﷺ said, the mountain of Uhud, we love it and it love us. The mountain of Uhud loved the Prophet ﷺ and his companion. How? We don't understand. We don't know it. وَلَكِنْ لَا تَفْقَهُونَ تَسْبِحَهُمْ إِنَّهُ كَانَ حَلِيمًا غَفُورًا. So in this ayah, Allah said, do they seek other than the religion of Allah? While to Him submit all creatures in the heaven and the earth willingly and unwillingly. Willingly is known, is those creatures. Willingly the heaven and the earth obey Allah, the angels obey Allah, the believers, the Muslims, from the jinn and from human being, obey Allah willingly. How about the disbelievers? Obey Allah as well, but unwillingly. Unwillingly. How? They are under the universal command of Allah. They die when Allah decides them to die. They eat. They drink. They sleep. They get sick. They go through all these which are the command of Allah. They don't want none of these. No disbeliever wants to die, to get sick. They wish they wouldn't need food and drinking and oxygen. But they must. They must, because this is the command of Allah Azza wa Jalla. They obey in Allah, but unwillingly. So in this Allah said, أَفَغَيْرَ دِينِ اللَّهِ يَبْغُونَ. Are they seeking other than the religion of Allah? And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned in the same surah, what is the religion of Allah? Al-Islam. As you will see in the same surah, rather inshallah, the same verse, yes, verse 85, the same surah. Now we are in 83, and this is 85, after two ayah. And whoever seeks a religion other than Islam, it will not be accepted. It will not be acceptor of him. And in the hereafter, he will be one of the losers. And whoever seeks a religion other than Islam, it will never be accepted of him. So the religion of Allah is Islam. And Islam, generally, is the religion that Allah revealed to his messengers. And especially, is the religion that Allah gave to Prophet Muhammad ﷺ, Al-Qur'an wa Sunnah. The Qur'an, the speech of Allah, 114 chapters, from Fatiha to Nas, and the Sunnah, the way of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you send down, descend the Qur'an unto the Messenger Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he also subhanahu wa ta'ala used to descend the Sunnah unto the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Ala inni utitu al-Qur'an wa mithlahu ma'ahu. Prophet was given two, not only one. He was given the Qur'an and the Sunnah, the like of it, the like of the Qur'an. So whoever claims that he only follow Qur'an, he's not following the sayings of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the teachings of Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, other than the Qur'an, then he's not a Muslim. He is not truthful in his claim that he follows the Quran. If you follow the Quran, Allah command you to follow both the Quran and the Sunnah. يا أيها الذين آمنوا أطيعوا الله وأطيعوا الرسول. Or you who believe, obey Allah and obey the Messenger. Obey Allah means the Quran, follow the Quran. وأطيعوا الرسول, obey the Messenger. Means his teachings, عليه السلام. Rather, Allah said, وَمَا يُطِعِ الرَّسُولَ فَقَدْ أَطَاعَ اللَّهُ. Whoever obeyed the messenger, he indeed obeyed Allah. He indeed obeyed Allah. Therefore, people with the sound belief, when it comes to the proof-wise, they don't differentiate Quran and Sunnah. It is the same to bring a verse of the Quran as a proof or to bring hadith of the Prophet as a proof. It's the same when it comes to the proof. Yes, it's different when it comes to speech. Quran is speech of Allah. It's a description of Allah. And the saying of the Prophet ﷺ is the Prophet ﷺ saying is action is allowances. But as a proof-wise, the same, no difference. If you want to look for now a proof or something, if this is allowed, this is not allowed, you don't have to seek Quran. Seek the Quran and the Sunnah the same way. Whichever you find is the proof. So the deen of Allah is al-Islam. So Allah said, أَفَغَيْرَ دِينِ اللَّهِ يَبْقُونَ. Do they seek other than the religion of Allah? So the religion of Allah is not Christianity, it's not Judaism, it's not Buddhism, it's not idol worshiping, it's not Sufism, it's not Shiaism, it's not Nation of Islam, it's not these newly invented ways. Rather, the religion of Allah is Al-Quran wa Sunnah. Al-Quran wa Sunnah, with a condition to be understood properly. And that is the way understood by the companion of the Messenger, sallallahu alayhi wasallam. You don't say, I go straight and I understand Quran, and I come up with this kind of understanding which contradicts to the understanding of companion. No, that's not accepted. The companion of the Messenger, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, as Allah mentioned his book, they are those who deserve Islam more than anyone else. وَأَلْزَمَهُمْ كَلِمَةَ التَّقْوَى وَكَانُوا أَحَقَّ بِهَا وَأَهْلَهَا. The companion of the Messenger, Messenger Muhammad, are those whom Allah is pleased with them, is whom those Allah command us to follow them. تَبِعُوهُمْ وَالَّذِينَ تَبَعُوهُمْ بِإِحْسَانٍ. So, the religion of Allah is Islam. وهو الاستسلام لله بالتوحيد والانقياد له بالطاعة والبراءة من الشرك وأهله. Islam is what? What's the definition of Islam in general? In general, what's the definition of Islam? If you are asked tonight by a non-Muslim, define for me Islam, what Islam is, what should you say? الاستسلام لله. نعم. سمرين. Barakallahu fiqh. Submitting to Allah what? Yes. Submitting to the tawheed of Allah. Submitting to Allah in tawheed, in oneness. Believing the oneness of Allah. This is number one. Believing the oneness of Allah. Oneness of Allah means what? Oneness of Allah in lordship. He is the creator, the owner, the controller. No one else. No man controls the universe, no angels, no other creature. It is Allah who controls everything, minor or major. You know that we don't know, we see, we don't see it. يُدَبِّرُ الْأَمْرَ مِنَ السَّمَاءِ إِلَى الْأَرْضِ أَلَا لَهُ الْخَلْقُ وَالْأَمْرِ. Indeed, to Allah alone is the creation and the command. So to believe the oneness of Allah in lordship, that Allah is the creator, the owner, the sustainer, the controller. Also, the oneness of Allah in worship, to worship Him alone. Don't worship dead. Don't call Jesus. Don't call Mary. Don't call Prophet Muhammad. Don't call saints. Don't call Sheikh Jailani. Don't call such Sheikh. Don't bow down for other than Allah. Don't swear by other than Allah. Don't ask paradise other than Allah. Don't ask protection from hellfire, saved from hellfire and calamity in this life other than Allah. For Allah is the controller of all those. The best of man, prophets of Allah, they themselves, who did they used to ask when they need help? Who did they used to call? Do we recite the Quran? Quran, recite the Quran. From beginning to the end, find any prophet, any messenger, whoever call, whoever invoke, whoever call other than Allah. You will never find. Why those people who say they're Muslims, calling the sheikhs who die in Africa, in Australia, in America. Why they calling the dead? Oh, such a sheikh, because of your greatness, because of your status. Why do you calling that sheikh? And he even doesn't hear you. He doesn't even know you. He would hear you, he wouldn't even answer to you. He was like you when he living in this worldly life. Like you, he used to eat, drink, used to get sick, used to get hungry. Maybe used to ask people and finally he died under the ground. How you call him? Ask him. Subhanallah. Likewise the prophets. So every prophet used to call Allah. Prophet Adam, Rabbana Zalamna Anfusana. Our Lord, we oppress ourselves. Prophet Adam. He didn't call anyone other than Allah to forgive him. Now in some religions like the Christians, iyadan billah, if someone commits crime sin, he go to the church and he say, oh, master or pastor or this, I did this, a'udhu billah. You don't need to do that. Ask Allah, your Lord, to forgive you. Yes, if you oppress man, a specific person, yes, you have to ask forgiveness, give apology to him, give his right back. That's different. But the sin you will commit between you and Allah, how you expose it to the other, how you ask someone else to forgive it to you. That's how the Christians make money from the human being, taking their wealth in falsehood. So, Prophet Adam, he asked Allah to forgive him. Likewise, Prophet Nuh, Rabbi inni maghloob, my Lord. You never find Prophet Nuh calling Prophet Adam. Then Prophet Ibrahim, from the biggest messenger of Allah, Rabbi ja'alni muqima salah, oh my Lord, make me those who observe the prayer. Make my children righteous. Prophet Musa, Rabbana innaka ataita fir'aun, oh Allah, is you who gave fir'aun such. Oh Allah, destroy fir'aun. Prophet Musa, he didn't call anyone other than Allah. He called Allah. He didn't call himself. He is Prophet Musa who talked to Allah straight. Prophet Musa talked to Allah in this while he was on the earth, even though he didn't see Allah. Subhanahu wa ta'ala. Nor Prophet Muhammad saw Allah. In the day of judgment, yes, the believer will see Allah in the Jannah. The biggest blessing they ever had is to see Allah, his face, Azza wa Jal. But the worldly life, no. Prophet Musa asked Allah to let him see him. Allah told him he cannot. Lantarani, you will not see me. Because he's not able. The way Prophet Musa is created in this worldly life is not a way he can see Allah, Azza wa Jal. In the hereafter, Allah created the people in a different way. In a different way. Even though they're the same, but Allah give them different descriptions. Therefore, they stand before Allah 50,000 years, not moving from that place. 50,000 years. Can anyone of us now remain standing 5 days? Is it possible? Not eating, not drinking, nothing? No. Even 24 hours, you fell down. 50,000 years. Yes, the people are the same people, but the description is different. The strength and much more, the remembrance, and a lot. Al-Muhim. Then this is Prophet Isa himself. Prophet Isa, who today you see those Christians calling him, oh Jesus, oh Mary, oh Jesus. Prophet Isa himself, who did he used to call? Allah. Rabbana, anzil alayna ma'idatan min as-sama. Prophet Muhammad, alayhi salam, who people call, a lot of Sufis, they call Prophet Muhammad. They say, madad ya Rasulallah. Madad ya Rasulallah. Or the Rasulallah give us what? What is madad? What is madad? Madad. Yani, what is madad? وَيُمْدِدْكُمْ بِأَمْوَالٍ وَبَنِينَ. Al-Muhim, they ask Messenger Muhammad support and assistance. How you ask Messenger Muhammad sallam support and assistance? A'udhu billah. Prophet Muhammad is another life. He is another life. وَمِنْ وَرَائِهِمْ barzakh. Between us and Prophet Muhammad is barzakh. Is a barrier. Those who are in the life after death is in another life called barzakh. We are in worldly life. We're different. We don't say about the barzakh life, life after death, anything but what we have proof for it. Because this is unseen to us. We don't say after death such take place. Such will not take place. How can you say that? Do you know that? You die and you come alive? Or do you have a proof from Quran and Sunnah? Yes, if you have proof. So, the point is Prophet Muhammad alayhi salam, last messenger, the greatest messenger and the seal of the messengers, he used to call Allah alone. إِذَا سَأَلْتَ What Prophet Muhammad said, إِذَا سَأَلْتَ فَاسْأَلِ اللَّهِ If you ask, ask who? Allah. وَإِذَا اسْتَعَنْتَ فَاسْتَعِنْ بِاللَّهِ Out there you have some imams, so-called imams. Because they are not truthful imams. Wallahi, they misguide men. They misguide the Muslims. Tell them, you know, you have a difficult, call such saint. Mention the name of the Prophet. Mention the name of such sheikh. Call him. This is calling Muslim in the name of Islam, calling the shirk. Then why you have problem with the Christians calling Jesus, calling Isa? Prophet Isa is bigger than those sheikhs, billions of times. Prophet Isa is bigger than Shah Abdul-Qadir Jailani. Prophet Isa, let alone someone else, is bigger than Abu Bakr Sadiq radiallahu ta'ala, the best of this ummah. Prophet Isa is a messenger of Allah, from the greatest messengers of Allah. And Allah has chosen the messengers. إِنَّ اللَّهَ اصْطَفَى مِنَ الْمَلَائِكَةِ رُسُولًا وَمِنَ النَّاسِ They have been chosen. So if the... Why you have a problem with? When the Christian call Isa and they ask, help, Jesus bless America. If you call in to someone who is not even a sheikh, who is not even a prophet, even though none of them has right to be called, because they both are slaves of Allah. وَالَّذِينَ تَدْعُونَ مِن دُونِ اللَّهِ عِبَادٌ أَمْثَالُكُمْ Those you call beside Allah are slaves like you. Prophet Isa alayhi salam, before Allah ascend him to heaven, he realized his enemy are going to attack him. He used to make dua, oh Allah save me, oh Allah save me. Allah save him. Even the Christians, they believe they kill him. They believe they crucify him, he was killed. But why are you calling him if he was killed? They say he's in the ground. Then why are you calling him? They say he resurrected, he came again. A'udhu billah, al-muhim. The point is, the deen of al-Islam is worship Allah alone. To believe the oneness of Allah. To submit yourself to Allah. His oneness means oneness in lordship of Allah. He's the creator, the owner, the controller. The oneness of Allah in worship means he's the only one deserves to be worshipped. Some people today, what they do? They go to the grave of such sheikh. And sometimes even they say this is the grave of Prophet Yahya, the grave of Prophet Musa. Allahu alam, is it true or lie? But they go to a grave. What they say is a grave of someone. And you see them calling, crying over it, wiping over themselves. They go to the graves and they start seeking blessing onto the walls. Anything close to that grave, the sand. Allahu Akbar. Is this Islam? And Prophet Muhammad, he command his arm, hair of arm, Ali. He said, Ali, whenever you see a grave which is above the rest of the grave, even it. لا تدع قبرا مشرفا إلا سويته. Any grave which is builded, which is higher than the other grave, make it even with the rest. Because it's one of the means of shirk. Now you see Muslims building graves. Grave look like a house. Wallahi, some of the grave, there is gold on it, gold. Some of the grave lights, flowers, perfumes, pictures. It's built the date, how this was great. That's some of them, even they make tawaf on the grave. Go to Egypt. See with your own eyes the qabr of Hussein, they say the grave of Hussein. People make tawaf, circle 7 times. Make 2 rak'ah of tawaf. A'udhu billah. This is Islam. This is what Prophet Hassan used to do. Yes. Where? Yes, in Iraq, ya akhi, in Iraq and in Iran, in Pakistan, in Bangladesh, in Somalia, mention almost every Muslim country except walhamdulillah Saudi Arabia. From corner to corner, you don't see a grave. That's why Sufia and the Shia, they hate Saudi Arabia more than any other country, because no graves. Graves, people are buried the Prophet the way he used to bury. Baqi', if you see Baqi', the grave of the Sahaba is there. People, they know it. This is the grave of Uthman bin Affan radiallahu ta'ala anhu. The grave of Umm al-Mu'mineen Aisha radiallahu ta'ala anhu. The grave of such, but normal graves. It's known. From that day, it's known. What do you think? Go and see the graves of the kings. Saudi kings, rahimahumullah. Like any other grave. Next to the Sheikh ibn Baz, next to the scholar graves. But the Sufi, they don't like that. They want graves be built. Minister of building graves, their government. Like the Taliban had it. Minister of building graves. So, alhamdulillah, no madahir shirk. What people do, still some Sufi, they do a lot of shirk. So in some areas, so, but they do that in secret. So they do magic, black magic. But this is hidden. Even at the time Prophet ﷺ, there were munafiqun in Medina. But openly, walhamdulillah, all over the world, all over the country. That's what they don't like. So find a lot of people. They don't hate that government. Many people, because of tawheed. Because of tawheed. And the true believer, he loves the people of tawheed. Even if they give you no money, they don't give you any visa. They don't give you job. They deport you. The people of Tawheed, the individual, the government, the organizations, regardless their color, their background, you love them for the sake of Allah. That's if we truly love Allah and His Tawheed. We love whoever loves Allah. أوثق عرى الإيمان الحب في الله والبغض في الله. The strongest hall of Tawheed, the, what do you call it? Hand hall. Jazakallahu khairan, is to love for the sake of Allah and to hate for the sake of Allah. So whoever you hear, he loves the Tawheed, he loves the Sunnah. You should love him for the sake of Allah. Whoever you hear, he hates the Tawheed. He spread shirk. He misguided the Muslims. He spread innovations. He changed the religion of Al-Islam. You have to hate for the sake of Allah, even if he's your own brother and sister. That's when you love for Allah. So the point is, walhamdulillah, is that if we recite the Quran, we find all the messengers, all the prophets, only worship Allah, only call Allah. And remember, making dua is bigger than the sujood, making sujood. Some people, they see someone making sujood for other than Allah, a'udhu billah. He makes sujood for grief, a'udhu billah. Hada haq, that's true. We seek refuge with Allah from that. But do you know bigger than that? Is making dua, is calling. Because Prophet ﷺ said, ad-du'a'u huwa al-ibadah. Indeed, the supplication, the invocation, the dua, it is the worship. It is the worship. So calling dua is only for Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala. وَمَا يَدْعُ مَعَ اللَّهِ إِلَهًا آخَرَ لَا بُرْهَانَ لَهُ بِهِ فَإِنَّمَا حِسَابُ عِنْدَ رَبِّ إِنَّهُ لَا يُفْلِحُ الْكَافِرُونَ فَادْعُوا اللَّهَ مُخْلِصِينَ لَهُ الدِّينَ وَلَوْ كَرِهَ الْكَافِرُونَ. Whoever dislikes to call only Allah, Allah mentions a kafir. Some people now, when they hear you saying call Allah, don't call Sheikh, don't call awliya, don't call prophets, don't call Hussein, don't call Ali, don't call anyone else, but call Allah alone. Some people, they get mad at you. They don't like you. Subhanallah. And Allah mentioned, Allah said, فَدْعُوا اللَّهَ مُخْلِصِينَ لَهُ الدِّينَ. Call Allah while you sing Allah in calling. وَلَوْ كَرِهَ الْكَافِرُ. Even if the disbeliever dislike it. So whoever dislikes the Tawheed, Allah mentioned, is a kafir. So to submit to Allah Azza wa Jal in His oneness, to the summit to the oneness of Allah in Lordship, that Allah is the creator, the owner, the controller. It's not just things happen just to happen. It's not coincidence. It's not what the atheists, the deniers of their Lord claim. Those who say it's by nature, mother nature, mother nature, mother nature did it. Earthquake take place, they say mother nature get mad. Who is this mother nature? What is this mother nature? A'udhu billah. All this is a denial of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So to believe the oneness of Allah in Lordship, Allah is the creator, the owner, the controller of everything. Also the oneness of Allah in worship, none has the right to be worshipped but Allah. La ilaha illallah. And from that is that whatsoever of blessing you have to believe deep in your heart is from Allah. وَمَا بِكُم مِّن نِعْمَةٍ. What Allah said? فَمِنَ اللَّهِ. Whatsoever of blessings upon you is from Allah. Some people, they believe when rain comes, when there is a prosperity, when there is, they believe it's because of the saints, such saints. Some area, that's what they believe, some Muslims, because of such saint is buried in that specific land, that's why rain comes. A'udhu billah. Rain used to come before that saint even born. Isn't that right? Before that saint born, rain used to come. Rather, before Prophet Isa alayhi salam, the messenger of Allah born, rain used to come. People used to have blessings. Who used to give them? Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala. It is He subhanahu who is giving it to them today, will give them tomorrow if He wants, if He wishes subhanahu wa ta'ala. So also from submitting to Allah's oneness is to believe the names and the description of Allah. Whatever Allah mentioned, whatever Allah described to Himself, whatever Allah called to Himself in Quran and Sunnah, we believe it. We don't deny. From that Allah is Alim, the All-Knowing. It's the name of Allah, the All-Knowing, Alim. From that, the description of knowledge, that all knowledge is for Allah. All knowledge comes from Allah. وَلَا يُحِيطُونَ بِشَيْءٍ مِّنْ عِلْمِهِ إِلَّا بِمَا شَاءٍ. You see people, they say they go to moon, they go to deep ocean, they make all these kinds of technology, it is because of the knowledge of Allah. It's because of the knowledge of Allah. Allah is going to open that door for them. Yes. For what reason? In order them to remember Allah, in order to worship Allah. وَمَا خَلَقْتُ الْجِنَّ وَالْإِنسَ إِلَّا لِيَعْبُدُونَ. But if they misuse, then it will be against them. So, to believe, to submit, one's submission to Allah Azza wa Jalla, to Allah is Tawheed. وَالْإِنْقِيَادُ لَهُ بِالطَّاعَةِ. And also, one is submission to the obedience of Allah, to obey Allah. That's what Islam is. If Allah forbid drinking alcohol, you submit yourself to Allah's command by leaving off drinking alcohol. Allah forbid watching this, you leave it for Allah. Allah forbid drinking this, you leave it for Allah. Allah forbid this kind of transaction and dealings in business, you leave it for Allah. Allah made this specific meat is unlawful, or food unlawful, you believe it and you leave it alone. This is the believer. And وَالْبَرَاءَةُ مِنَ الشِّرْكِ وَأَهْلِ. And to free yourself from idol worshipping and the idol worshippers. And the idol worshipping and the idol worshippers and the shirk itself. So in this ayah, Allah said, أَفَغَيْرَ دِينِ اللَّهِ يَبْغُونَ. Do they seek other than the religion of Allah? وَلَهُ أَسْلَمَ مَنْ فِي السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ. While to Him submit all creatures, in the heavens and in the earth. طوعا وكرها, willingly and unwillingly. All the creatures obey Allah. This is the aqidah of a Muslim. There is nothing just to happen. It happened by itself, by Mother Nature, أعوذ بالله. لا. That's kufr, ya akhi. طوعا وكرها. All the creatures obey Allah, submit to Allah Azza wa Jal command willingly and unwillingly. وَإِلَيْهِ يُرْجَعُونَ. And to him alone shall they all be returned. There will be one day that all of us will be returned to Allah Azza wa Jal in order to be rewarded, everyone for what he did, what he earned. So how is it accepted that someone to take a religion other than the religion of Allah while all the creatures in the heaven and the earth submit to Allah? So the religion is the religion of Islam. Allah said in this ayah, قُلْ آمَنَّا بِاللَّهِ. Say, O the Messenger of Allah Muhammad, we believe in Allah. We believe in Allah. Some people, they don't know what we believe in Allah means. I mentioned this before, I repeat it. Someone came to me one time. He said he's a sheikh of such masjid here in Georgia. And he wants to invite me to participate in the lectures being given there. I said, you the sheikh of the masjid? He said, yes. I welcome, we sit down, I talk to him. Because me knowing in reality that many imams, many sheikhs of masajid, they don't even know the tawheed, wallahi. Yes, someone may say, oh, how you say, ya akhi, this imam, sheikh, he doesn't know tawheed. Ya akhi, this is a reality. Leave the emotional things. You go and see with your own eyes. It's reality. Don't deny the reality. Yes, a Muslim may not know. Even the salah the Muslim is performing may not know. Didn't it happen that at the time of the companion? At the time of Prophet ﷺ, a man prayed in the masjid, his salah was invalid. Prophet told him 3 times, go back and pray. You didn't pray? If that's the time, Prophet ﷺ, how it doesn't happen our time? Al-Muhim. So that sheikh invited me to that masjid. And then, after we sit down and we talk, I ask him a question. And I had a reason to ask him a question. I asked him, did Abu Lahab, I asked him, did you ever hear a man call Abu Lahab? And Abu Jahl, he said, yes. Tabbat yada Abi Lahab wa tab. He recites Surah Al-Masjid. I say, okay. Did Abu Lahab and Abu Jahl and their people who opposed the Messenger Muhammad sallam, the Quraysh, did they used to believe the existence of Allah Azza wa Jal? I asked him that question. Did the enemy of the Messenger sallam, Abu Jahl and Abu Lahab and the like, those who used to torture his companion in Mecca, kick him out from Mecca, did they used to believe the existence of Allah Azza wa Jal? That was the question. He said, no, they were not believing the existence of Allah. Because if they would have believed, they would have worshipped Him. If they would have believed, he said, they would have worshipped Him. They didn't believe, he said, the existence of Allah. Because if they would have believed, they would have worshipped Him. Is that the correct answer? Both answer is wrong. They used to believe the existence of Allah. Allah mentioned that in his book. And also they used to worship Allah. But they were not used to single out Allah in worship. This is their problem. So what the people of knowledge call Tawheed al-Rububiyyah, the Lordship of Allah, that Allah exists and He controls the universe and everything, Quraysh used to believe that. Allah mentioned that in many ayah. Who created? They say Allah. Who created the heaven and the earth? وَلَئِنْ سَأَلْتَمْ مَنْ خَلَقَ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَلَا لَيَقُولُنَّ اللَّهِ وَاللَّهِ اللَّهِ They swear by Allah that Allah is the creator of the heaven and the earth. خَلَقَهُنَّ الْعَزِيزُ الْعَلِيمُ They say, who created is Al-Aziz, the mighty, Al-Alim, the all-knowing. How you say they didn't believe the existence of Allah? And they say Allah is the creator of the heaven and the earth. وَلَئِنْ قُلْ لِمَنِ الْأَرْضُ وَمَنْ فِيهَا إِنْ كُنْتُمْ تَعْلَمُونَ Say who the earth and whatever in it belongs to. سَيَقُولُونَ لِلَّهِ They will say to Allah. Not only that. قُلْ مَنْ رَبُّ السَّمَاوَاتِ السَّبْعِ وَرَبُّ الْعَرْشِ الْعَظِيمِ Say who is the Lord of the seven heavens and the Lord of the great throne. سَيَقُولُونَ لِلَّهِ They will say Allah for Allah. Quraysh, this is the answer they given. They believe that Allah has a throne and that the throne of Allah is great. They believe that there are seven heavens, not only one. So they used to believe the existence of Allah. How then a sheikh saying they didn't believe the existence of Allah? How is he saying? Because really, Tawheed, these masajis, they don't teach Tawheed. They just teach Islam, Islam, Islam. What Islam is, no explanation. As for him saying, if they would have believed the existence of Allah, they would have worshipped. They used to worship Allah Azza wa Jal, but with shirk. Allah mentioned that in his book. فَإِذَا رَكِبُوا فِي الْفُلْكِ دَعَوُوا اللَّهَ مُخْلِصِينَ لَهُ الدِّينَ فَلَمَّا نَجَّاهُمْ إِلَى الْبَرِّ إِذَا هُمْ يُشْرِكُونَ When they are in the ocean, for instance, and they are in a difficulty, who do they used to call? دعوا الله. Allah said that. They call Allah. How they call Allah? مخلصين له الدين. While they single out Allah in the religion, in calling, in worship. They call Allah alone. فلما نجاهم إلى البر when Allah saved them to the land, to the ease, إِذَا هُمْ يُشْرِكُونَ Now they commit shirk. What it means? They call other than Allah. So the tawheed is to call Allah and the shirk is to call other than Allah. So Allah mentioned that. Quraysh is known, they used to make umrah. They used to make hajj. They used to fast the shura. Quraysh used to fast the day of Shura. Yes, they are those who build the Kaaba. They used to make tawaf, all this. They used to make i'tikaf, they used to vow. They used to honor the house of Allah, haram. Remember that authentic narration, Sahih Bukhari, Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhu said, O the Messenger of Allah, إني نذرت في الجاهلية أن أعتكف ليلة في المسجد الحرام فقال عليه السلام فأوفي بنذرك عمر رضي الله تعالى عنه said Oh the Messenger of Allah in the jahiliya time I vow to make i'tikaf to remain in the Masjid al-Haram in the Masjid al-Haram night whole night he vowed that whole night he's remaining in the Masjid al-Haram he's not leaving Means he's asking the ruling of that. What should he do now? This is a vow he made for Allah. Prophet ﷺ said, فَأَوْفِ بِنَذْرِكَ Fulfill your vow. Fulfill your vow. Complete the act of worship you were doing for Allah. Do you think if Umar would have made that vow, because it's Jahiliyyah time, shirk is widespread. If he would have made that vow for other than Allah, for Lata or Uzza or Manata, Prophet ﷺ would tell him to continue? Na'udhu billah. So they used to make i'tikaf. They used to make nadr, vow. They used to honor the haram. All this is before Islam. How you say they didn't believe the existence of Allah? It's because these people, when they have seen in Quran that Allah has mentioned, the idol worship reject to say La ilaha illallah. They refuse. They thought that means they don't believe the existence of Allah. No, what they reject is to single out Allah in worship. To single out Allah in worship. Don't commit shirk. All act of worship addressed to Allah. Remove these images, these idols in the Kaaba. Remove it from the Kaaba, from the top of Kaaba, inside the Kaaba, around the Kaaba. Hundreds of idols, statues. The picture of Prophet Ibrahim and Musa and Ismail, they say, is inside the Kaaba. Remove these pictures. Remove these idols. Rocks. Don't do that. Call Allah alone. This is what they refuse. They say, أَجَعَلْ أَلِهَةَ إِلَهًا وَاحِدًا. Did he make the gods? So much gods, we are only one. We only call in Allah, only. That's what to them is very surprise. أعوذ بالله. Allah said in this ayah, أَفَغَيْرَ دِينِ اللَّهِ يَبْغُونَ. Are they seeking a religion other than the deen of Allah? How someone seek a religion other than the religion of Islam? How someone seek a sunnah, a way of worship other than the way of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam? Therefore, no good innovation Islam. No good innovation Islam. Some people, they do a lot of act of worship. Prophet never did it. You ask them why you do it. They say, this is innovation, but it's good innovation. Bid'atun hasana. There's no good innovation Islam. Is there good alcohol in Islam? Yes? Is there good stealing in Islam? Good zina in Islam? A'udhu billah. Good kufr in Islam? No, likewise, there's no good innovation in Islam. They make what they want and giving good name. But that doesn't change the reality. The religion of Allah Islam is complete. Allah completed. Al-yawma akmaltu lakum dinakum. Whoever wants Islam, pure Islam, alhamdulillah, is there Quran and Sunnah. According to the understanding of companion, no addition. This is very important. Because out there you have a lot of imams, masajidis, who is spreading innovations, spreading something changing the deen of Allah Azza wa Jal. And a Muslim shouldn't be in a state, everyone who has an imamah, who has a lihya, who is in a masjid, he is mashallah. No, that's not the way it is. The way is the sunnah of the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam should be adhered to. Whoever adhered to it, he is the upon sunnah. Whoever doesn't, he is upon innovation. We ask Allah al-Karim to protect her from innovation. Wa sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Nabi Muhammad.